Hey guys, what is up? It's Avi again with more or less for Persona 4 Expert Mode, trying to reach 100% because I keep on goofing. So, a lot has happened. Today you should... It will be best for you to go to sleep early and get ready for after the real culprit. Sleep. Teddy! I can see you. It seems that you've come to the velvet room in your dreams again, but something is different this time. You don't see Igor or Margaret. Hi, Teddy. Teddy is sitting here, not noticing your presence.
Where am I?
Sensei.
Sensei? Why are you here?
Question is, why are you here?
I see. How mysterious. There are so many things I don't know about.
And that's okay.
But I did realize something. I've been thinking all this time about who I really am. But I couldn't find the answer. I was no one from the start. Humans live in the other world, and shadows live in this world. From the beginning, that's all there was to it. I was just a shadow in that world.
And? Everyone's worried.
You're always so kind, Sensei. I figured something out. That day at the hospital, I realized that I really can't do anything.
No one could do anything for Nanako, honestly.
As soon as I thought that, I lost consciousness. Then when I woke up, I was inside the fog. Shadows can't stay in the human world. They aren't allowed. I walked and walked, but there was nothing all around me. Just when I started thinking that I couldn't go anywhere, I heard the noise of a car.
And that's why the car stopped.
And then I was here. I remember lots of things now.
But if you're a shadow, you shouldn't remember, right?
My world is a place shaped by human thoughts. One day, a shadow living in that world awakened to human emotions.
Maybe it was a little girl's shadow.
But humans and shadows are completely different entities.
No, they're not.
So he made himself forget that he was a shadow. He wanted to forget. He wanted people to like him. And that's how he came to look like this. I really am stupid. What the other Teddy said before, in the end, it was all true. No matter how much I search for myself, I have no self. There was no me to begin with. I'm just a shadow that took a different form so humans would like me. It would have been better if I had never remembered. But I...
Oops, sorry, but I did.
Well, probably turn back to a regular shadow soon. Oh yeah, Sensei. One day, when you meet Nana-chan in heaven, apologize for me.
She's alive!
Tell her, I'm sorry I couldn't do anything.
She's alive.
I'm really sorry.
you told Teddy how Nanako came through because she wanted to see you!
Not a chance. Wow, that's wonderful.
Now you gotta keep your promise and meet up with her.
I'm so glad. Glad that I could at least hear that. My heart feels so much lighter now. I'm starting to feel sleepy. What a strange place. It feels so soothing. It's not like my world. Something just feels so nostalgic about this place. Could this be your dream world, Sensei? Aha. But I wonder why I met you here. What am I supposed to do now?
We should get together and fight the real culprit.
But I don't know what to look for or how to find it. No matter how hard I think, there's too many things my little brain can't understand. But I do understand one thing now. I'm glad that I met you, Sensei.
You can sense Teddy's pure and deep gratitude. Hillel. You can all fuse Hillel, but I already have it.
But I have to get going. This is your place. It doesn't seem like somewhere that I'd be allowed to stay. Goodbye, Sensei.
No, Daddy! Before you know it, Teddy is gone, and Igor and Margaret are sitting here once again.
It seems the words in your memory weren't the only things you summoned here. This is a room for guests who have an ego that can be nurtured. Shadows, mere fragments broken off from the ego, have no place here.
Meaning he has no ego?
The water strength has moved a single stone that had stopped, returning it once again into the flow. Very interesting.
Igor has a meaningful smile on his face.
Well now, it's about time we departed once again. This vehicle is still on its journey. There is no reason to tarry here for long.
That is why the game is not over yet, and I can get 100%. That is why.
Margaret?
We're ready to go. Let us depart.
You are every inch the guest I had anticipated. Now, it's time for you to return.
Wake up, bitch!
I am even more intrigued now as to where this is all headed.
We're gonna fight the Izanami. Spoilers, I'm gonna have a bad time.
We'll be waiting for your next visit.
Excuse me. Junez's electronics department.
How did it go. Did you find Teddy?
I did.
No, and no one's seen him either.
Oh, that annoying little furball! Just when we're at a turning point in the case, too.
We have no choice. Let's pursue Adachi for now.
Whoa! Look how dense this fog is! It's gotten even worse than before.
What the? There's this malicious aura everywhere. It feels completely different from the last time I was here. I think we'd better hurry. Give me a sec to try finding Adachi.
Take your time.
Does this mean both this world and ours are getting messed up?
I think so.
Our glasses work on the fog on the other side. It can't be normal. And I heard more people are falling ill because of the fog. I wonder what's going to happen.
Shit's gonna happen. That's what's gonna happen.
I sense him. Adachi's definitely in here.
Are you serious? Which way?
Hold on.
So he did come to this side. Well, that settles it. There's virtually no doubt remaining that he's the true culprit. Once we capture him, solving the mystery of this world and the rest of the case can't be far behind.
Then maybe we'll find out where Teddy came from, too. Man, where is that bear, anyway?
Well, I can say for sure he's not here. And I know Adachi is here, but I can't track him down myself. Gee, Ted, why aren't you here when we need you most?
Nana-chan! Hold on! I'll get the doctor!
No, stay here! Where did you go, Teddy?
It seems she's asleep again.
Nana-chan told me that she heard my voice. She heard me say, hang in there!
It could be that her frankly miraculous recovery was because everyone's voices reached her. Even unconscious, people are capable of hearing others' voices.
My voice. And theirs too. Everyone.
In any case, there are too many things we don't understand about her condition, what caused it. We're doing our best. But it's difficult when everything about her illness is a total unknown.
Unknown.
Well, if anything happens, please send for me.
If I'm an unknown being, then the way I can change is unknown too. So all I have to do is make them not unknown.
Jin's doing her best. Sensei and the others are probably fighting now, too. I'm just a shadow. But Nana-chan cheered up when she heard my voice. So what if I'm just a shadow? There must be something I can do.
Exactly.
I can't just give up thinking about things. That's why I came back here. Right, Nana-chan?
Teddy's strong will that allow him to accept and overcome his weakness has awakened his heart's true power. Yo, Kintochi, Kintochi Dochi, Kintochi Dochi. Teddy's person has reborn. Kintochi Dochi, Kintochi Dochi. Has transfigured into Kamui.
Need to get back to the others. Hang in there, Nana-chan. I'll be back soon.
You better be.
It's no use. I can only tell that Adachi is here, not his exact location.
Risei-chan.
If only Teddy was with us.
Da-da-da-da!
Didn't he say his nose is practically useless now? And could he even help us find that bastard?
Nope. He'd be no help at all. But he was always there to support me whenever.
That bear's a loudmouth, but he's nice to have around. He's always so full of energy.
He's lighthearted and always optimistic.
My cat wants food. Give me a second.
I'm all right. I just got a little dizzy. It's so dense, it's hard to see through it.
Why don't we call it a day? It won't do us any good if you collapse.
I agree. If Risei-san became fatigued, even if we found Adachi, our capacity in battle would be reduced. Moreover, it's almost nighttime. We should return to our world for the present.
Came so far to run smack into a dead end.
I know he's in there too. What's wrong with me? My powers are completely useless.
Don't give up, Risei-chan.
Teddy?
You little, where the hell were you?
I'm sorry.
You idiot! Bad bear! Bad! You're so late! Who do you think you are?
Risei-chan? Are you faking?
No, stupid!
Sorry. I want to help you all again.
You better.
You know how much trouble you caused, you dumb bear? Where the hell were you?
I'm sorry. I figured out a lot of things. Stuff about me and that world. I wanted to tell you all.
You listen to Teddy's conversation since he finally understands who he really is, that he is only a shadow, that through he was at his wit and he was able to come back to your world.
A shadow? You mean you're one of those things we've been fighting?
Yep, just like the ones you all know about. Shadows are suppressed human thoughts given form. Everyone has them inside.
Wait, you say you're a shadow, but you didn't attack us. And you kept telling us from the start that you wanted to bring peace and quiet back to that world, right?
But in the end, I was just an ordinary shadow. Nothing special about me at all.
Actually, yes, because you are different. Just that.
I did everything I could until now to try and make my world peaceful.
That was a reason for you not to become a shadow, like the others.
But instead, the weird fog started seeping out into this world, too. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. If I really was special, then maybe...
It's no big deal. I mean, we weren't expecting much from you in the first place. And about you being a shadow, we pretty much figured you were something like that anyway.
Huh? What are you saying?
Here I am pouring my heart out to you, and you say you thought I was something like that anyway? No normal person would think such a pretty bear could really be a shadow.
So what's the problem with being a shadow?
It's true that you may have been born that way. But you now possess the power of persona. A shadow is suppressed power. Once controlled by the ego, it becomes a persona. Doesn't it follow then that you must have developed an ego? Whether the ego masters its shadow or the shadow awakens to its ego. The only difference I see is the order in which the process occurred.
Oh! Teddy's practically human then!
I'm the same as humans?
Because you wanted to be.
You keep trying to figure out who you are, just like all of us here. You can't do much on your own. You really aren't that special. See? What's so different between you and us? Of us were pretty much a group of misfits to begin with, too, right? You fit right in, man.
I beg your pardon? Who are you calling a misfit?
Her face is so pissed off.
Isn't that just you, Senpai?
Hey, that's not something a detective would say. Or an idol, either. Geez, stop crying, will ya? It's not the time for that. While you were gone, we figured out who murdered the announcer and Senpai. It was Adachi.
Huh? Adachi? That total goofball? Wow. I didn't notice at all. Looks like I'm pretty blind to that sort of thing.
Hmm.
But you all know him. If you can't find someone like that, I don't think I can help you.
Just try.
Like I said, we're not expecting much from you.
Well, the main thing is, it's hard to get pumped about this without someone nice and fuzzy around.
Yeah, what Kanji said.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
All right, now that the band's back together, let's take it from the top. Starting tomorrow.
It's been a while, but I'll do my best to look for him too. Leave it to Fuzzy.
You've taken another step towards the truth. start fresh again tomorrow. Each of you decide to go home for today. So we're gonna leave it for today. So thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you guys on the next episode. So yeah, don't forget to actually vote for the next let's play that I'll be doing. Either is Persona 1, Persona Q, or Tokyo Mirage. Next let's play will be up to you guys, like always. And once again, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Until then, take care. Bye bye. Thank you.